quick.
So you're this false shepherd we've been hearing so much about. Caused a mess of trouble at the raffle.
You Fitzroy?
Nothing but.
I got no quarrel with you or your Vox Populi. This is my airship you're hanging me out of, and I got perilous need of it.
Really? Because it sure look like old Comstock's airship to
me. Listen, I ain't looking for a fight.
There's already a fight, DeWitt. Only question is, which side are you on? Comstock is the god of the white man, the rich man, the pitiless man. But if you believe in common folk, then join the Vox. If you believe in the righteous folk, then join the Vox.
I just want my ship.
And the Vox shall give her to you. But first, you must help the Vox. Down in Finkton, there's a gunsmith who can supply weapons to our cause. Get our guns from him, and you shall have your ship back.
Before she lights out of here.
The most common complaint I hear from the working man is that they are unhappy with their lot. Why torment yourself, I ask? The ox cannot become a lion, and why would you want to? Who wants all those responsibilities and worry? You do your job, eat your food, you go to sleep.
You wanna know what we do to pretty little stowaways? Or maybe you don't.
Hey! Just stop
Stay
for
away
a minute!
From me. Stay away!
I just wanna talk to you! Elizabeth! Just hold up for a minute! I'm not angry with you! Hey, watch out! Move it! Move!
Just stay back!
God damn it!
I am not going with you!
Don't go in there!
I have no need of one such as you!
No, no, no!
Gotta be another way.
Oh.
thing!
Do not attempt to follow me, Mr. DeWitt!
Elizabeth, I've made an arrangement to get our airship back!
You can get us out of here!
Yes! I just need to supply enough weapons to arm an entire uprising.
And where will we get these weapons? From one of our many friends and allies?
A gunsmith in Finkton should be a walk in the park. What do you say, partners?
You're a liar, Mr. DeWitt. And a thug. But you're also my only means of reaching Paris. Don't get too comfortable with my company, Mr. DeWitt. You are a means to an end.
Lately, I've been hearing a whole mess of funny new ideas. Paid vacation.
Daisy Fitzroy.
She's either a great hero or the worst of scoundrels, depending on who's doing the telling.
She's good for an airship. I don't care if she's the Queen of Holland. Would you take a look at this lock?
Got it. Over there, a service elevator. Should take us down to Finkton.
And get ourselves killed in the bargain. Picked.
All done. The gunsmith Chenlin wanted for me. Daisy Fitzroy.
Looks like our guy's drawn attention.
That's not good, is it?
No.
Slate's locker. He must have worked here. This is my mother's diary. Why would Slate have it? My husband claims the child was created from whole cloth by divine will. I am a believer, but I am not a fool. His bastard shall not be raised under this roof. My mother. She had me locked in that tower.
Elizabeth.
I just want to get out of this city. Please.
share with you my personal creed. What is the most admirable creature on God's green earth? Why, it's the bee! Have you ever seen a bee on vacation? Have you ever seen a bee take a sick day? Well, my friends, the answer is no. So I say, be the bee! Be the bee!
Hello?
Mr. DeWitt?
Yes?
Hold for Mr. Fink, please.
What's going on?
DeWitt, Fink here. Listen, my boy, we've had our eye on you, and I can tell you right now that you are our top candidate. Top! Now, my associate, Mr. Flambeau, will help you with anything you need.
What the hell was that?
I have no idea.
He seems oddly pleased to make your acquaintance. Well, the man's got an ego.
Some say to me, Fink, why is it that we get paid on tokens that are only good at the company store? Well, I'll tell you what, I'll be damned if I let any of you poor folk get robbed at some shady establishment. You see, the Fink company store brings you Fink products at a price designed specifically for the Fink worker.
Mr. DeWitt, welcome to Finkton. You'll find a variety of supplies here that should see you through your visit.
What does Mr. Fink want with us?
Excuse me, miss, but Mr. Fink's interest is strictly in the gentleman.
But why?
So sorry, young miss, but any questions regarding the gentleman's application should be taken up with Mr. Fink directly.
Does this strike you as good news? Doesn't strike me as good news.
Do you know what Daisy Fitzroy and her anarchist cronies want for you? Strike, they say. Throw down your tools, they say. Why, I tell you, the moment you do,
here it is.
We'll see what those hyenas are.
Founder of Buddhism, spent 49 days under a Bodhi tree until he achieved enlightenment.
Hello? Hello? Mr. Lin? Chen Lin? Is anybody here?
What happened here?
Someone worked this place over. Local constabulary, no doubt.
Do you hear that? There's someone downstairs.
Excuse me. Ma'am, I'm sorry to bother you. We're looking for Mr. Lin. Mr. Chen Lin.
Booker.
Mr. Lin, not here. He gone.
Gone?
They take flying squad. I pray, Gautama Buddha. Pray, give husband back. Give back to Mei Lin.
Where did they take him?
Club. Everyone take to good time club.
Where is this club? Ma'am, please, where is this club?
Booker, we'll find it.
Just leave her be.
Why not Vox Populi help Chen Lin? Why not Daisy Fitzroy help Chen Lin?
Cops. The kind who probably got their boot on Lin's throat asking him how well he knows Daisy Fitzroy.
Isn't she the one we're working for?
As a matter of fact, it is. Let's figure out where this good time club is.
Much obliged.
I'll try to keep you stopped. I don't much care for you, Mr. DeWitt. I must admit, you know your way around a brawl.
That song before.
I don't suspect anyone's heard that song. I'm sorry about what I said at the docks.
Yeah. Can't see how I might have changed your sense of that.
You protected me.
Job's a job.
There it is, Mr. DeWitt.
Now we just need to head inside and find Mr. Lin. And just call me Booker.
Find Chen Lin and get the hell out of here.
Now, all I ask is that you finish what you started to it. Wouldn't want to disappoint the other applicants. Our first candidate is a veteran of Peking. Now, what's that they say about old soldiers? Frankly, my money's on you. He's something of an old hand at handling explosives. Only man I know who hasn't lost a limb working with them.
Fireman, be careful!
Great!
responded this.
With the automata, wants to replace all our security with machines. I'll give the old boy credit, though. It would be fewer mouths to feed.
Patriot, over there!
Open it.
Interested in your job, Fink.
Now, I know all about your little job for Fitzroy. But do you really want to take her offer over mine? Do you know how many people would kill to be head of Fink Security? You're a tough nut to crack, Mr. DeWitt. A tough nut. But I promise you this. I will get what I want.
There's a door over here. I think that's the way down.
I had thought you a fool, dear brother, when you told me that you heard wonderful music trumpeting from holes in the thin air. I began to doubt your mental integrity. But not only have you made your fortune from these doodads, you have...
Chen Lin, cell number 9.
Seems right up your alley.
Come on, give me something
cheap. I used to work for folks like Fink.
Really?
Yeah, I was with the Pinkertons. They call us in when the workers got restless.
To do what?
Demonstrate the folly of men striking, throwing down tools.
You hurt people.
I'll tell you this. Sometimes there's precious need for folks like Fitzroy.
Why?
Because of folks like me.
It's done.
Down here.
Is that not cruel? To forbid the mixing of the races. Is that not cruel? To give the vote to the white man and deny it to the yellow, the black, the red. Is that not cruel?
Elizabeth.
But is it not cruel
this
to...
This is it, isn't it?
Yep. Number 9.
Done.
Drown your flock under an...
But you can't blame me for looking after my own interests, can you? Now I know Fitzroy has come calling, but I think you'll find your business with her has come to an end. Lions walk with lions, DeWitt, not hyenas.
Now we need to find someone else to make those guns.
No.
Dead is dead, Elizabeth.
Dead is dead.
What? How the hell did...
I see heads.
Why are you following us?
Who sent you? Comstock? What do you want with the UCP?
From this angle.
Dead.
Listen.
And that angle?
Alive.
Fucker. Chen Lin. This is becoming rather awkward.
The body's gone.
It was never here.
It's another Columbia.
A different Columbia.
The same coin.
A different perspective.
Heads.
Tails.
Dead.
Alive.
We have to go through to this other Columbia, but how?
It's like riding a bicycle.
One never really forgets.
One just needs the courage to climb aboard.
If we go into the stair, I don't think I'll be able to bring us back. Are you sure you're ready?
Okay, open it.
Look, there's no blood.
And no body.
It's another world, Booker. Another Columbia.
Something tells me one dead gunsmith ain't the only thing that's changed.
Booker, grab that lockpick.
You unlock this?
I can do that. Got it.
Daisy Fitzroy. Come on, you piece of work.
I don't understand how Chen Lin is alive now.
We're in a world where he was never murdered. Somewhere we'll find out why, I suppose.
I don't suspect you can change something like that and have everything else remain the same.
These men.
I killed them. They were dead.
Not in this world. Look at their noses.
What is going on here, Sandark? As my head of security, you're one to find out.
Business makes my head hurt.
Is a trickster. They live to stir up trouble. So you beware the hyena.
Hear anything?
Huh?
No machines. No tools.
Let's go find that gunsmith. Maybe he She's upstairs now.
Booker, look. The shrine. It's a figure of Comstock now.
Mr. Lin? Chen Lin? Excuse me, Chen Lin?
Who are you? You speak up! Speak up! Can't hear you over all these machines! Very loud!
I'm Booker DeWitt.
Stand back! These machines various. Wait downstairs with Mrs. Lin.
Daisy Fitzroy sent us. We need to talk to you about getting some weapons.
Machines? Very dangerous. No place for stupid people. Want to lose pretty head?
Mr. Lin.
Downstairs!
What is wrong with him?
Remember him dead in that cell? Maybe in some way he remembers that too. How would you reconcile that?
I don't know.
My husband? Calm his troubled thoughts.
Excuse me, ma'am. I'm looking for Mrs. Lin.
I'm Mrs. Lin?
No, I mean a little Chinese lady. She was...
Booker, this is Mrs. Lin.
They took Chen's tools. What's he got without his tools?
Well, your husband is a bit out of sorts.
If he could work again, maybe... If he could work, he'd...
Mrs. Lin... Can you tell me who took your husband's tools?
Goddamn police. They took them and locked them up in the impound in Shantytown.
Would having his tools back fix his mind?
Who cares? We're not getting any guns if Chen Lin doesn't have his tools.